Week 17, dude.
Holy
the
shit.
Weeks keep blurring.
It's an NFL season.
Yeah, it is.
It's an entire NFL season.
Hell yeah.
That's how long we've been
doing. We're in the playoffs
this.
Now.
This is the playoffs. This
Fuck
is week
yeah.
one. Wild card, baby.
Hell yeah.
Actually, we probably got a first round bye based on how good this has been.
Yeah, we're number one seed, no doubt.
Number one seed. You're coming into the link, dude.
It's Patriots, dude.
Oh, we're the Pats, dude. Fuck yeah. We are the Patriots. It's Trump's team, baby. Oh,
dude.
Man. How are you?
Good.
I haven't seen you, man. You've
I
been
know.
Up in the Big Apple.
I've been MIA, dude.
We literally went opposite directions from Philly.
You
upgraded and went to a bigger city. I went west, went into the Badlands.
I wish I did. I hate it. I hate that place, dude.
You hate New York, yeah, so do I.
I mean, it's nice. It's, you know, it's cool for what it is, but fucking Jesus, that is the breeding ground of fucking pussies.
Yeah.
Everyone up there is like, this is where you come to get tough, and it's like, I swear to God, I was doing a show. Next door to it was a fucking fedora shop. I'm not exaggerating.
Yeah, of course.
It was just a room of just like dumb hats. It was retarded.
And business is probably booming in
oh,
there.
Oh, dude, fucking
dickhead hats. A dickhead hat shop in Brooklyn.
I hate when girls wear hats too.
Oh, it was, yeah, I guess it was for ladies too.
No, it was for I think it was for guys too.
You don't like when girls wear hats?
No.
I like when they wear baseball hats.
That's it. With a ponytail
like
sticking
yeah.
out the back. That's it.
They look like
even that
the
Jay
chick
Simpson
from Mortal Kombat.
Who? Sonya Blade?
Yeah. Didn't she wear like a SWAT team hat?
Maybe. Maybe one of the later ones.
I don't know.
I don't, yeah, maybe if you're Jessica Simpson, you can pop the ponytail out the back, but
yeah.
like, don't wear fucking, like when a girl wears like a Michael Jackson hat, I'm like, ugh, ew.
Damn,
it sucks.
It's a good white boy out there.
Out there trimming hedges.
That's a working
and shit.
White boy.
Yeah, it is.
That looks like you.
Hell yeah, dude. He's got long hair too. He looks good.
So
but yeah, dude, it's all I heard.
Gay?
It's just everyone doing one joke. Just being like, so I'm bisexual and I date women and men, and I'm unhappy half the time because I'm dating men. And this
yeah.
girl like, yes. People
yeah.
really do that in the audience. A guy came out and was like, you know, I'm just figuring out this black experience. Some black dude was like talking about his life, and this fucking white chick in the front row just goes, yes. It's like, dude, that has nothing to do with you.
Yeah.
It's like that, just constantly.
Yeah, that's why
it sucks.
I posted on the main board that Get Out sucked, and every single dude disagreed with me. But they were all from fucking, they're all like Alabama fans, Nebraska fans. Like, they're from a part of the country that they never have to deal with that.
Yeah.
So, like, in Get Out, there was, to them, it was like a subconscious, like, oh, this is about black people in America. I didn't get that.
That's funny.
You know what I mean?
It was just like a
like,
fun thing.
They were actually like, oh, wow, I didn't even realize the context, the subtext of white people can be racist. I didn't even see it. But like us, we're getting it jammed down our fucking throats.
Yeah.
So we walked into that movie like, all right, here it comes.
Yeah. I'm telling you, the movie itself didn't bug me. It was everyone being like, this is the best movie ever. My dog's popping its head over the fucking board. It looks kind of
funny.
Pretty
adorable.
Yeah, that it was everyone being, it was funny because the people praising it was basically what the movie was making fun of.
Yeah.
Just being extremely like woke white liberals
yeah.
who aren't. And they're like, there was people like, I swear to God, I was hearing people like, well, I would see it again, but I can't. And it's just like, dude, why the fuck would you
yeah.
go back and see that?
It's not that good.
It was okay.
Yeah.
It was
anyway,
literally.
Let's not do the same podcast.
I know.
But
dude, that's all it is.
It was funny to get a backlash from like actual white hicks that were like, hey man,
that was a good movie.
That movie had some important fucking information. It's like, yeah, I guess it did if you're from fucking Tuscaloosa.
Yeah.
You know, if you're just getting that information.
But I didn't know I couldn't grab a black dude and be like, you're
yeah.
strong as hell, man.
Yeah. I've been we've been at every open mic for the last 2 years getting slapped in the face
dude.
With it from every fucking white bitch.
It's the same fucking joke.
Actually,
over
it's
over.
Funny. I just told you I was listening to Norman and Joe List's podcast, and they were talking about that. They were
really?
Like, Brooklyn's supposed to be like the hive of like coolness, and now they're all actually just sheep.
Dude.
That are like, every comic gets up there and is like, white guilt.
Dude.
Privilege.
It's every if you don't have a joke about it, they kind of look at you like, ugh, like, what are you
meanwhile,
doing?
Meanwhile, I'm fucking doing every fucking weekend, I'm doing black shows.
Yeah.
Where I'm literally the only white guy in the room, and I'm going up there and saying, like, Get Out fucking sucked.
Yeah.
And they're clapping.
Fucking laughing.
They're like, yeah, it did suck.
It was all right, yeah.
Actually, they liked Get Out. They did. They one thing that shocked me, do you remember at Stand Up at the Movies, it might have been a different one. Anyway, me and Matt, the only white guys in the room, basically, and it was right when Roots 2 came out. You might have not been at that one.
I don't remember.
It was just me. Roots came out, so that was all they were talking about.
Oh, okay,
They were all like, fuck this. Fuck this movie. I was like, wait, you guys don't like slavery movies? Like, I thought that was who these were for.
Yeah.
They're like, no, we don't like being the fucking victims in every movie. And I was like, well, it's not for us. Trust me, we fucking hate it. Yeah. You know who it is for. It's for the white pussies.
Is that, dude, they love it, dude.
To be like, so, oh my God, look how awful we were.
And, dude, it's fucking, it's just sick. I'm telling you, I have a friend who is a black lady who got just, like, messages in her inbox after Trump won, like, I'm with you, girl, don't worry, from white chicks. And she was like, leave me the fuck alone. You're a fucking psycho. If you sent one of those, you're a fucking weirdo.
Yeah.
So weird. I'm with you, girl.
Well,
I got your back.
You know, they probably did that because after the nightclub shooting, the gay club, was that in Orlando?
Yeah.
I remember there were a bunch of statuses that were like, here's how you can take care of gay people right now. Like, check in on us.
Yeah, yeah.
And
remember
one
that
was like, send us a meal.
Yeah, it was like, like, fuck,
make
you,
us
dude.
Food.
Yeah, you're like fucking 1,200 miles away from that, dude. Get out of here. Fuck off. That's insane.
Man.
Yeah, I saw that. Like, send us a meal. And
yeah,
it's like,
here's something you can do to help. Make us a meal. Was that on fucking
Facebook.
Everyday Feminism or Facebook? I forget.
But was if it was
same
on
thing.
One, it was on the other.
Same
yeah.
thing. Oh God, I haven't talked about Everyday Feminism in
yeah,
a while.
Yeah, dude, that
I
gets,
away
it gets
from
you
that.
Fired up.
It gets me. Well, it's just ridiculous.
Yeah, I don't watch it anymore. I don't listen to. I just like block all that shit out, and I'm like, eh, you guys. It's the same people that have been following every trend ever, and now this is the hot trend. So
it's like, all right,
when you guys peter out something. Now they're dressing like lumberjacks, so maybe they'll all become carpenters or something.
Yeah,
Carhartt's in right now. I noticed that.
Carhartt is in.
Carhartt's in, dude. It's so funny.
Carhartt's sick though.
It's like official lesbian gear,
which sucks because I actually like it. Carhartt's
nice.
Fucking nice.
It works well, dude.
But I really wear it because I am like I have three outfits. Carhartt's durable, dude. I need it.
I know.
Yeah.
Now it's like the official sponsor of like fucking tough lesbians now.
speaking of tough, they used to wear leather.
Really?
Lesbians used to wear like leather jackets and shit back in the day, like a long time ago. And I was home.
Holy shit.
And I don't think I talked. Yeah, because this was last week. I had those. I had a gummy bear before I went to my family dinner, and I had had a gummy bear before, and it didn't do anything. So I was like, all right, let's quadruple the dosage. I had four
Christ.
Of these things. I hope to God Caitlin's not listening. She'll actually be mad at me. So I was a little high. Mm-hmm. I took it earlier in the day.
Yeah,
and then I was still high all day.
It just crushed.
And then
you,
I
dude.
Got to my family's house for dinner, which don't. Get high for a family dinner. That's the first time I ever did that.
Learned that in high school, dude.
Super, super uncomfortable.
It sucks.
And, like, I was sitting there. My mom made this meal that was just... It was supposed to... She tried to make this, like, chicken. It ended up just being fucking soup.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I was like, is it supposed to be fucking soup? She was like, no. It's supposed to be, like, a light sauce. It was just literally just soup. And I was high. I was like, this is soup. I was fucking dying.
They had no idea.
They had to have.
Really?
Well, no, I'm always pretty much a dickhead. But,
yeah.
But, like, now Caitlin didn't know. No one knew.
That's funny as
but
shit.
My eyes were dark red and I was laughing the whole time. I don't think they would expect that from me.
Exactly.
I wouldn't expect that from
Sneaky.
Me.
Sneaky.
I would never expect
that
from me.
If you're eating
me.
The gummies, dude, they wouldn't know.
And I was high enough that I was like, I'm getting high by myself. Like, usually, like, when I was younger, if I ever got high, it would be like, yeah, I'm getting high, and tell people.
Yeah.
This was just me getting high, like, to just get through the day. Like, just a sad fucking, like, I want to feel weird at dinner.
You got too high.
And I got too high. And then we were sitting there watching TV, and ABC has this show right now. It's, like, called Together We Rise or something. And it's all about different, like, social movements in America, of course.
Yeah.
Primetime ABC, they're showing black people marching.
Yeah.
It's like, come on.
Dude, it's the cow right now.
They're
dude.
Just getting us. Like, we don't need that.
Yeah.
You need it a little bit. You need to understand history, but you don't need it as fucking. Here's our fucking Sunday night entertainment.
Well, you need to understand history. That's all just like pure out of context.
Yeah,
like,
it is.
Check this out. And you're like, whoa.
Yeah. But we're watching it, and the one episode was about gay people.
Uh huh.
And there was just this thing about the Stonewall Inn in New York, which I actually, oddly enough, I knew about all this shit because I took Gays in America at Westchester. I took
a history
class on homosexuality in America. So I know a lot, like Harvey Milk, all that shit. And the Stonewall, but there was just this article that they showed on the screen that was like, officers break up den of homosexuality. And I was so high, and I was laughing so hard about it. Like, thinking of a bunch of dudes coming into a den with sticks and, like, hitting gay people. Like, get out of here. Knock it off.
It's like the cops from The Simpsons. Like, get out of here.
Yeah, yeah. Please. This is weird. But then I was like, oh, man, Dad, you must have been, like, homophobic as fuck when you were a kid.
Yeah.
Like, you must have called people fags and shit like that. And he was like, no, we never. I was like, you never said, like, this is gay? He was like, no, we just called people douchebags. I was like, oh, yeah? He's like, well, yeah, we didn't know. They didn't know people were gay.
Well, that was also, that was a fist
fight,
dude.
How fucking funny is that? Yeah, but they didn't know.
That's insane.
Like, until they figured out that gay people existed when they were, like, in college and out of college.
Holy fuck.
And I was like, what'd you think? Because my fucking mom's brother is gay.
They just thought he was
They were like,
weird.
He's just weird. I was like, what'd you think about your friend? Like, because they had gay friends. Like, he never liked girls, and he always hung out with the girls.
We thought he was a nerd.
Yeah, they're like, we just made fun of the way he ran. Like, we had no idea.
Oh, it's so fucking funny. Yeah, that shit's, dude, I'm telling you, dudes like 50, 60, that's not funny to them.
Yeah.
Like, grab your dad's fucking ass, dude.
Oh, my God.
He'll fuck you up.
Oh, my God.
He'll kick your fucking, it's not funny.
But then, like, because we were raised with, like, being gay is, like, totally acceptable.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, they didn't even fucking know about it. So, like, it was mind-blowing to me to find out that people were like, what the fuck is that?
Dude, it's insane.
You know?
It's, well, I mean, the fully gays acceptable movement was, like, 2000s.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
80s and 90s were like...
Yeah, yeah. Well, they were getting fucking AIDS, and people were like, that's what you get, doing all that weird shit.
Yeah. Like, there was... I never heard anything about the... What is it called? Like, the Westminster Baptist Church or whatever?
Westboro.
Westboro?
Westminster. Yeah, it's a dog show. Dogs hate fags. Dog hates fags.
I kept seeing... there's all these signs up in New York that have, like, out on businesses. Especially in Brooklyn, they have, like... A guy, like, holding a baby in a trench coat, and it's like, we accept refugees and immigrants, and it's like...
Oh, my God.
Dude, and this is on a fucking, like, vape shop. So it's like, this is purely to fucking stroke yourself off. Dude, the one of them was on a construction site, which I thought was kind of devious. It's like, come on in, boys.
Yeah.
Pick up the shovel, my brother.
Come work for $5.
Yeah. Hold this shovel, my brother.
Yeah, that's...
This dust.
That's odd. I wonder what'll go on with that.
It's just people stroking themselves off.
Yeah,
so it's literally, that stuff is all for people to stroke themselves, to be like, I'm going to start buying my e-juice here. It's like, all right, dude.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And it kind of sucks because it takes away from the people that are actually doing good.
Yeah.
Like, the people that believe in, like, Syrian refugees and, like, want that. And they're like, hey, we need to help these people.
Yeah.
It gets ruined by some fucking white dude in a scarf that's like, oh my God, I love refugees.
Dude,
what?
I heard a comic one time be like, I'm basically a refugee on stage. And it's like, dude, either was there some dude who looked like Wario trying to chop off your feet or not? Like, you're not like, it's either yay or nay.
Yeah.
There's not like shades of it.
Was there a guy dressed like a fucking genie trying to toss you off a roof?
I just, that dude is coming in with all of his boys in his like big Jafar outfit. You're just like, oh, fuck. Yeah, dude, I'm basically a refugee. It's like, no, you're fucking not.
Oh, my
Shut
God.
Shut the fuck up. See, everyone's trying to get on, dude. That's, dude, the Lord McKeever, God bless his soul, has the best bit about white women trying to switch.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It literally is. It's like the fucking playing the game. If you're playing like NHL and all of a sudden you're losing, you just pause it, switch your controller to the other side, and you're like, what? No, I'm playing with these guys now. Fuck you.
Yeah.
You didn't pass me the puck.
Yeah, his bit about a sinking ship and them
dude.
Trying to get on the lifeboats. It's like, fuck you. You're going down with this fucking ship.
It's so fucking true. They've cut. Dude, honestly, I think, especially Jewish people, that now it's like we're minorities, it's like, eh. I think it should be up
here
to...
Here we go.
No, I think it should be up to other minorities to vote. So it's like they'd have to go around to like the four main and be like, Jewish people be like, hey, black people, are we minorities? They're going to be like, fuck no, y'all in the Illuminati. You're not fucking in. Then they're going to go to like fucking...
That's exactly what black people would say.
Yeah. And then they go to like Middle East and they're obvious enemies like, nah, fuck off. Then they could maybe sway Asians, but they're still fucking outdone.
Yeah, I watched... last night I watched two... I stayed up late as fuck last night. It's why I got
Did
here
you?
Late. Yeah, I stayed up till like 4. I was watching Ali Wong's special.
How was that?
Well, the first time I watched it, I just saw a pregnant Asian lady, and I was like, oh, this is just people stroking their dicks.
Yeah.
This is going to suck.
Uh-huh.
I watched like 5 minutes, and I was like, fuck this.
Yeah.
But then I heard a bunch of people saying how she was like a really good comic.
Yeah.
So I watched it, and yeah, she's really good.
She's good.
But in that, she was like, she played up the Asians are minorities too.
Yeah.
Things, yeah, which was funny. But she had some. She was really funny.
I mean, I'll give them. I mean, dude, they come in. I mean, they're third, fourth place. It's like black people, the
Asians?
Ultimate minority. I'm talking about like in terms of being a minority.
Dude, drive down to fucking Drexel's campus right now.
Yeah.
Tell me
definitely.
What you think about fucking Asians being a fucking repressed, oppressed class.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They come in like. I mean, they get goofed on a lot. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, they get made fun
they
of.
They get bullied.
They fucking bring it on themselves.
Dude,
Asian people, fresh off the boat, Asian people do not assimilate one bit.
No, dude.
They stay full fucking Asian.
Yeah, I mean, most people coming from somewhere are just like, they're like, fuck, I can't speak the language, and they cluster. But,
yeah,
dude,
yeah, yeah.
It's like...
That's what happens.
Plus, there's also the thing of if you come from somewhere, and then you have people coming from there, too, and you're Americanized, it's kind of like, you're like, ah, you fucking traitor. That's everywhere.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yankee boys for Jamaicans and fucking...
Then I watched Amy Schumer's special. That came out last night at 3 a.m.
Did it really?
Yeah, it came out today. And
how
so
was that?
It just it was pretty shitty.
Yeah.
It was pretty shitty, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Nothing new from her.
It's like my pussy.
She talked a lot about her pussy. But, I mean, I could see how it was funny. Like, I've been working on trying, because... The only comedy I like is usually from my fucking perspective.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I like black dudes, I like white dudes.
Yeah.
That are talking about shit that I deal with.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it makes sense to me that ladies would like it.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense. Yeah, I don't know.
Like, there's times where she stops and, like, she has a bottle of wine as her drink on stage and she'll, like, stop and, like, look at it and be like, I love you.
It's like Chelsea Handler, basically.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hello, vodka, it's me.
Yeah,
I you're right though. That's just
my
a
sisters love that shit.
Exactly,
they
I can tell you a world of people
they
who are
loved
like
loved Hello Vodka or whatever.
Yeah, sometimes I cook with wine, and sometimes I even put it in the stuff or whatever.
Yeah, yeah,
it's
yeah.
Like, all right, that's
yeah,
good.
You
that's
like nice. Getting drunk.
Yeah,
you know what they do though? A lot of female comics now, and what's cool is for chicks to act like bros. Like,
yeah.
That's funny. Like them to talk about sex like they're
yeah.
dudes. Like, ooh, I'd fucking hit that. It's like,
yeah,
that's
yeah.
not.
Yeah.
It's not what you guys do.
No.
Is it?
Nah.
I don't think.
Maybe like the polyamorous
maybe the ho, maybe the who is.
Not even, dude. The whores don't want to be whores. They just can't help it.
This is not a hot cast. This is more of just an actual... This is us.
Just two boys, dude.
Two guys breaking down the world.
Two
right
open-minded
now.
Libs, dude. All I'm doing from now on is woke comedy. It's being like, he's the worst. And I'm like, ew. He's
nice.
Literally orange. That was a punchline. Time. He's orange.
Yeah, I've had this conversation. It's like comedy's supposed to be counterculture. Not necessarily, but it's supposed to be like, that's like, so I'll go on stage here or like other cities and be like, yeah, white guys are the fucking best.
Yeah.
But then if I'm doing a show in fucking Harrisburg.
Yeah.
I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, because
like if I get on stage in Harrisburg into a room full of white dudes in camo, and I'm like, we're the fucking best, right? They're going to be like, fuck yeah.
And you're like, ugh.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. You want to fucking be like, I'll go on there and be like, black guys are the shit. And they're like,
fuck you, dude.
Like, Trump's a fucking retard, you dickheads. But if I got on stage in Brooklyn and I was like, Trump's a retard, they'd be like, oh my God.
Dude, it's literally all it is now. That's the big thing. It's like, go up there and just regurgitate a popular opinion. Just go up there and be like, oh my God, like, I'm so sick of it.
Yeah,
and everyone's
well,
just like,
I mean,
yes.
That's what separates a good comic from
an asshole.
A bad comic.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
that's true.
Like, a lot of those people aren't doing anything.
No.
You know? Like, if you look at a special that does that,
yeah,
it's garbage. If it's coming from a white dude or a white chick that's like, Yeah. Trump's awful. But, like, Michael Che, yeah, he should do that.
Yeah.
Because that's his fucking world.
I don't know. No, if you're a fucking white chick from the suburbs, it's like, you got to knock it off. You got to shush.
And you know why? It's because of their privilege.
Dude. Exactly.
That's the weird thing.
To go march and be like, this is fun.
I'm
going to take a picture.
The weird thing about you and I is we are actually liberal.
Yeah.
We are actually aware of race and racism. So when you see people that are it's a white chick that's like, racism's like really bad.
Yeah.
It's like, shut the fuck up.
Yeah, shush. It doesn't affect you. Shut up.
It's your doing, you fucking idiot.
Talk to your dad about this. I don't need to hear it.
Yeah.
Oh my God, my dad voted for Trump and I haven't talked to him.
Like, I listened to Garrett Smith.
Uh-huh.
He has a podcast. It's actually good.
Yeah. I like it.
It's like it's not even like a comedy podcast. It's just like an actually good
movie. They know
a
lot
about
movies.
Yeah. But they had Satoyo and Abeko on about Get Out.
Yeah.
And normally, if it's Satoyo and Abeko talking for 3 hours, I'd be like, shut the fuck up. But when they were talking about Get Out, it was good.
Yeah.
Like, they had their fucking side of it and their perspective. What I didn't like was hearing the honkies on there be like, oh my God, it was eye-opening.
Yeah. It's like, dude, really?
Nah, I shouldn't have said any of that. Fuck it.
The honks, dude. The honks are out of control right now.
The honkies are getting wild. Those guys, they know what they're fucking saying.
They're good boys.
There was good, honest. It was good.
Yeah.
It was actually good. Like, I sat and listened to them talk about it, and I was like, all right, I get it.
Yeah.
Like, I understand why people would like Get Out.
Yeah.
If it fucking really matters to you.
Exactly.
But when it's a bunch of white fucks that it doesn't matter to.
Dude, yeah.
It's annoying to hear
it's
them
like
be like, you need to see it.
It's like BuzzFeed 10 things black ladies are tired of hearing the movie. It's like,
yeah.
That's what it was. It was like a list.
Although I did grab Britney's hair.
Yeah, she told me. Snagged her
it
hair.
It was a pure fucking reflex. Like, I went to, like, say hello, like, put my hand, or, like, my arm around her, and I got her hair, and I was like, oh, I like this. And I, like, held it, and I was like, fuck, I didn't mean to do that.
But that's the funny part. It's just like.
Yeah, I understood.
Whatever, yeah.
Yeah, I was like, I usually don't say that, ever. In fact, I usually don't like that.
Yeah.
I'd never have grabbed a black person's hair and been like, oh, my God.
This feels so cool.
Yeah. In fact, honestly, I think black hair is disgusting.
How would you know? Dude, that was an argument I got in one time about cultural appropriation and people writing books. Like, they're saying, like, a white dude can't write a book about a black woman.
Yeah,
it's like,
I remember that. That was your lady. That was your lady.
Yeah, NB, dude.
She got you.
Baby.
Yeah, Matt's a stalker. Anyway, I think we've covered that one, right?
Uh-huh.
All of our longtime listeners know.
What else is cracking, bro?
I don't know. Just had a nice weekend.
Yeah.
Oh, last night, this is pretty fucking gay of me. I was going to drive. I usually stay on Sunday, and then on Monday I drive and do the Lancaster mic and then come home. But I just didn't feel like doing that mic. So Caitlin was having her friend over to watch The Bachelor at 8.
Ooh.
And I was kind of stuck in the apartment. So I didn't watch it because it's awful.
Yeah.
But eventually I came out and they were like, will you get us blizzards? So, dude, last night, and this was right when I saw Murdoch post on Six's fucking wall. So I was like, fuck that guy. Fuck this bullshit.
You're out on a blizzard run.
I was all fired up. I was making a blizzard run listening to fucking DMX. Dive, like, my boys ride for me, all this shit. I was like, fuck yeah, dude. This is my squad. And I was getting blizzards to bring home. I got 3 blizzards. And I ate a blizzard and watched The Bachelor. I watched The Bachelor tell all. Yeah, I was like, fuck that guy. And I sat down and ate a Reese's Blizzard.
Like, wait, which one's getting voted off?
Yeah. No, it was the tell-all, dude.
What's the tell-all?
At the end, it was before the season finale, they do a thing where they bring all the chicks on, and they all talk about the show.
Are they? Is he really fucking all those chicks?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. My friend was on The Bachelor. He was on The Bachelorette. My friend Brian.
I try to get them all pregnant.
That's a good move.
I wouldn't use a condom. I'd get them all pregnant and sue ABC.
Yeah, dude, they have this thing called the fantasy suite. So he took 3 chicks and spent the night with 3 different chicks.
What?
Yeah, in a row.
That's crazy.
It's a fucking insane show, man.
It's nuts.
It's insanity.
I just thought it was kind of like tongue-in-cheek, like, we made it out.
No, dude, they really fuck.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why do girls sign up for this?
I don't know. And then how are you supposed to have a relationship afterwards?
Yeah.
Like, oh, yeah, remember right before you proposed to me, you fucked three chicks? That's fucking wild.
That's insanity. Did your boy get married from it?
No, he got fucking booted.
He got booted? Oh, yeah. He was on The Bachelorette?
He was on The Bachelorette. He was one of the dudes.
Ew, even worse.
And he fucking cried.
Did he really?
He cried when he was leaving.
Oh, my God.
That's all I said to him. I was like, dude, no matter what happens, don't fucking cry on that.
Dude, that fucking sucks.
I think he said he was crying because he had to say goodbye to all his friends.
Dude, I don't know what the fuck's worse.
Yeah, either way.
I'd rather cry.
He was going home from summer camp.
Oh, like, God.
It's so much fun.
That's disgusting, dude. I would never.
Be on the... Yeah, I mean, Jesus Christ.
How, dude? Ugh,
anyway. He's not. He didn't sign up for it. His friends signed him up.
Dude, I mean, I get it. I get it. You know, you get on that show. Did he fuck the chick?
I don't know.
He won't say? I wonder if he signed it.
I don't know.
Yeah, who knows?
He probably did. But...
Dude, like, imagine if your daughter... I mean, fuck,
He actually had some... From what I remember, he had some reservations about going on the show.
Really?
And, like, his parents and shit were like, I don't know.
Does she just pick, like, the biggest dick? She's like, oh, this guy had the biggest dick. He wins.
Dude, the fucking one I was watching, every chick was smoking hot.
I know.
And, like, dude, the guy on it's a fucking weird psycho.
Of course. Dude, who else would do that?
Can you imagine if you have to be on TV and be like...
Ladies.
Well, so, like, he came in and sat down and talked to all the chicks. And they were all like, why'd you... Like, I thought we had something. Why'd you cut me? And he's like, we did have a beautiful relationship. It was fun while it lasted. What a fucking psycho.
Jesus Christ. Dude, ugh.
Oh, this was great.
Are they rich? Is it like the idea?
A
that, like,
couple of them are rich. The guy, I don't know if the guy's rich.
Are the girls are rich?
Yeah.
She's a rich woman. A couple of chicks are rich. Over.
One chick was an immigrant. It was hilarious. She's a Russian immigrant.
Oh.
Came out of an orphanage. So she told that story and all the chicks were like crying. Like, it's so brave. She was like, when I was young, we didn't have much money, so we had to eat lipstick. I was like, that's more expensive than food, you fucking
nasty
idiot.
Bitch, get out of here. Dude, yeah. That's literally... Ugh. Imagine trying to fuck your way on TV through some fucking, like, fucking Brent. The Bachelor.
God.
Like, your life is so fucking void of any pleasure. Like, well, I'll suck this guy's dick on TV and maybe get on the magazine of some fucking... grocery store tabloid for like five seconds.
Talk about talentless fame.
Yeah. Ugh.
Well,
my gymnastics gym will take off after I suck this guy's dick on ABC.
Oh, God. Yeah. And they fuck on ABC.
Jesus Christ.
It's like, yeah, I spent the night in the fantasy suite with it. It's like, Jesus Christ.
It's got to be like, those dudes are probably like, oh, God. Or it's just full on like strangulation, like looking in the mirror, muscles like American Psycho sex, dude.
Oh my God,
that's fucking what a disaster. Crazy. What if he's just getting strap attacked the whole time? The whole time, these different chicks are butt fucking. I like that.
Yeah, it was pretty hard to watch, unbearably bad.
Ugh.
There were viewing parties.
Yeah.
Like where a bunch of people will watch it.
Well, there's ironic viewing parties, too.
No, there's real ones.
I know, but there's the whole flip side of people who are like, we're above the show, we're just going to watch it for fun. It's like, don't fucking watch it.
Yeah, I think...
Of course it's stupid.
Yeah, it's one of the dumbest fucking things I've ever seen. Actually, you know what?
That show?
I just realized I went to a viewing party. I was with Brian when they aired his episode, the first episode.
Did you bring the blizzards?
Yeah, I brought... No, fuck you. I sat there. He was like, you were the one person I didn't want.
Oh, I would never be here. Oh, you must have came like we were talking about with like fucking Jafar coming, like the fucking Sultan. You're like,
yeah,
oh,
dude.
Fuck.
I was the ISIS of fucking Mechanicsburg.
I would, dude.
I was like, if this is gay, dude, I'm throwing you off the roof.
If I got on The Bachelor, I'd pay and have you killed. I couldn't face you. I'd like take him out. I'd be on there like, I just think we have a special. I'd see him. I'd be like, we have a special connection. Cut his throat.
Yeah, we're kind of friends. We're friends.
Yeah. That's one of those things that's just like...
Oh, it was the fucking Osbournes.
Yeah. Oh, that's the Osbournes.
It was the Osbournes. They were there when
How
I
Mrs.
talked
o
about
feel
coming
about
in my dad's fucking mouth. Yeah, so it's not like...
Yeah.
Like, from parent to parent, they can't be like, well, your son's worse, you know?
It's weird. That's a weird thing.
What, being on The Bachelor?
Yes. Bachelorette, even.
Yeah, Bachelorette. Yeah.
Just nothing but Eskimo brothers, dude, hanging out.
Everybody trying to fuck the same chick.
Ew.
Wow.
Yeah, it's fucked.
That's brutal.
And that's like a wholesome show, kind of. You know, that's like ABC
primetime. It's supposed to be them, like, falling in love. And, like, this is how I found true love was I fingered 18 chicks.
I wore a condom for some of them. Some of them I didn't. Butt fuck too. It's like, out of all those odds.
I mean, it sounds great from a guy's perspective. Yeah. But then when you see it, it's not.
No.
Not great at all.
Then it's on television. Then my mom's seeing all this shit.
I mean, it's
shit.
Like you and 19 hot chicks in a mansion. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much what dudes are blowing themselves up for in
it's
Syria.
It's 19 fucking... Yeah, really. Yeah,
people are literally
dying.
Trying to kill themselves for that situation.
Yeah, that's true. That is true. So you and fucking 19 airheads can fucking... Have sex in an all-inclusive resort in Riviera del Maya.
I thought you were calling Muslims airheads. I thought you were calling them airheads. Oh, my.
No. Yeah. No, that'd be funny. I read a thing today that said diaperhead. That made me laugh pretty hard.
Who calling
Muslims diaperheads?
Jeez.
I was like, Jesus Christ. But in terms of being offensive, that's like the least offensive term for them.
Diaperheads?
Yeah.
It's pretty bad.
It's true.
Anything with heads in it.
Yeah, that's true.
Is bad for anybody.
That's true. Knob heads for fucking British people.
What do you think? You want to take a break?
Yeah, let's take a break.
All right.
Review. This has been a lot. We've been talking for fucking ever. Back from the break, fully recharged.
Yes.
What is up?
Oh my God, we're back again.
Am I sexual? I was dancing to that song one time at a wedding, and I was like really gyrating my hips. I turned around, I was like, "Am I sexual?" And like my mom was like right there, and I was like, "Oh fuck, sorry, mommy." I was like really getting into it.
Oh man, did I ever tell you the time I saw my mom naked?
No.
All right, so I said I was leaving the house, and I went back in to get something, and the phone rang, and it was for her.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like. Yeah, she's upstairs. I was like, hold on. I yelled, Mom. And she didn't answer. I was like, fucking Mom.
Oh.
And I didn't know she was just trying to get in the shower. So I walked upstairs to her room, and the door was open, and she walked out of the bathroom fully fucking naked.
Yeah. It's happened to me before.
Oh, it's the worst.
I caught like a panty shot one time when I was younger, like topless panty shot, and I was like, bah.
I saw it out of, like, I turned my head immediately.
Full frontal?
Yeah, I got home, but it was all out of the peripheral. It was all in my periphery.
Dude.
But it was enough to know some things that I shouldn't.
I mean, your dad went on what? He probably took her out to like at least a fucking dozen dates for that, and you just fucking wandered in as a kid.
No, I was pretty old.
Really?
It was old. No. Yeah, dude. I was
really?
Like in college.
Oh, that sucks. I was like nine. So
I was
like,
old enough to be like, this is horrific.
Fuck, what'd she say?
She was like mad. She's like, get out. Get the fuck really? Out.
Really?
I handled it better than her.
Jesus Christ. My one time I was like...
I started laughing. I was like, holy fuck.
I don't know what... Oh, man. I'm really happy that hasn't happened to me in my adult life.
You remember seeing your dad's dong when you were a kid?
Probably. I used to bring the... I'd literally, like Friday, I'd have to bring the phone into him while he took a shit. He'd be taking a shit. He'd be like, get up here. I'd be like, fuck. And I'd have to go in, just pinch my nose. And I'm like, here. Fucking big pasty thighs and belly leaning forward. I'm like, dude, this sucks.
Yeah. I remember seeing my dad's donger.
I had to have seen my dad's dick. I can't remember it.
Yeah, they don't care when you're a kid, especially like dudes from that time.
Oh, I mean, definitely like peeing and shit in urinals.
Geezers
and,
do not
yeah.
give a fuck about
Dude,
their dong.
Geezers slash dong.
Yeah.
No fucking problem.
That's because they don't know gay people exist.
That's true, too.
They're just like, this is nothing.
Dude.
Might as well show this guy my elbow.
My dad just got a pair of camo Crocs. That's like his new fucking foot gear right now.
Oh, man.
And his big thing was that like... He was, like, showing them off to me. I'm like, oh, that's kind of cool. And he's like, yeah, I didn't get the blue ones. And I was like, why? He's like, blue ones are gay. Like, dude, all Crocs are gay. Like, he might have got camouflage ones. He's like, or at least people will know I'm fucking straight. If
Jesus
I
Christ. There was a fat dude that used to do stand-up in Harrisburg that used to always wear orange Crocs. He fucking sucked. Oh, man.
That's fucking sick.
Yeah, I saw some dongage when I was young.
Did you?
When I was a young lad.
I didn't peep a lot of dongage.
Never saw my sister's naked, thank God.
That's good. I never have either.
Never
I saw my
that.
Mom's aunt one time taking a shit. fully naked. She was like 75.
Damn. She'd get naked for the dump out.
She was, yeah.
Some people do that, well, dude.
You don't know either. There's
dudes.
A lot of ladies that old wear fucking bras that are like the exact color of their naked body, so maybe she had like a bra on. But like, dude, it was like, I just remember being little and thinking she was built like one of the mom from the show Dinosaurs, where they do like Nakamama. God. It was just like, I was like, oh, Auntie Eileen. I took her to Outback once.
I had an Aunt Eileen.
Did you?
Yeah.
This is my mom's aunt's or my auntie's. But we went to Outback one time when I was like 17 and I was high as fuck. She was old. She was like an Irish immigrant.
Yeah.
And I brought her back. I was playing rugby, and I came back from a game. I got super stoned.
Rugby is
like,
gayer than blue Crocs, by the
rugby's
way.
Rugby's fucking sick.
Rugby's
dude.
For white dudes
rugby's
that suck at real sports.
Rugby's the camo Crocs of fucking sports.
Rugby
dude.
Is for guys who can't play football. Go ahead. Go ahead with your story.
I left the team. Anyway, so I was playing. I got back from playing rugby, and me and my – we'd all – yeah, it isn't really a real sport because we would get stoned after every game, sometimes before practice. And so, yeah. Like, I come back, and it was the last night. My Auntie Eileen would watch me sometimes. My parents would go away, so it was like I would drink beer in front of her. It was just – I did whatever
yeah,
I wanted.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd fuck my girlfriend in the other room. It was just a pure fucking
jeez,
blast.
Man.
It was fun. So, yeah.
Jeez.
So the one time, I didn't know. I didn't think she knew what the fuck I was doing.
Yeah.
So we went out to dinner the one time, and I'm stoned to the fuck. Like, I was stoned to the point where, like, I was trying to put sweatpants on out of the shower and was like, oh, like, falling over. And I come downstairs just, like, out of my mind, and she's sitting there with, like, a little umbrella all dressed up. Like, you said me to go out to dinner? And I'm like, oh, fuck.
Oh,
so
fuck.
Me and this 70-year-old Irish lady hopped in my Ford Explorer, drove to Outback Steakhouse. She fucking, my parents gave me, like, $70 in case we went out to dinner. She fucking crushed the whole tab.
Damn.
She ate, like, appetizer, soup, entree, dessert.
Damn.
And I had to sit there the whole time with this old lady just, like, out of my mind, just like, oh, my God.
My grandma crushes food.
Does she really?
Yeah. She fucking, she ate all the chicken parm that one time.
Really?
I still haven't forgave her for that. I came back over to my parents' house to get the leftovers. She was
oh,
like,
yeah,
they're
yeah.
gone.
They're gone.
I was like, all right.
It's that fucking Great Depression mentality.
And she boozes hard as fuck. She's
dude.
A geezer that fucking boozes.
They're built better than
just
us.
Just a glass
apparently,
of vodka.
Apparently, people our age are getting colon cancer a lot.
Really?
Yeah, we're fucked.
I'm on a fast track.
Are you?
My butthole's a mess, yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah, push out farts all day.
I've been farting bad lately.
Well, you... Yeah.
I'm telling you, dude. My asshole is never... It's never clean.
Oh, God. Yeah, you were saying this.
It's never.
It's something you gotta watch.
Always.
You gotta watch out for that.
What?
Having a messy butthole all the time, that sucks.
Who cares? It's over, dude.
Yeah, but it itches.
No, it's not. It won't get itchy for me. It gets
really?
Slick. It gets
ew.
Fucking, like, oily.
You have an oily butthole?
Sometimes I'll feel it. Right now, I'm good. I can just kind of, like, tell.
You
it's like
an
1 to 10.
Butthole.
It's like an unwiped ass is a 10. I'm lingering at, like, a 3 all the time. And that's comfortable.
Nice.
You hit the 7, dude, that's when it starts itching and burning.
Jeez. Do you always have a messy butt?
I guarantee if I wipe my ass right now, it's going to be like a marker running out of ink, dude.
Good God, dude.
It's not fully messy.
Do you have like shit streaks on your underwear?
It's like skid marks, but I don't have them. But I
my dad, I do remember
I don't
that.
Buy white underwear.
Yeah, I remember that as a child.
Bacon
first off,
strips,
geezers always wear
white,
like, white fucking Speedos. What is that? Those are the most uncomfortable fucking underwear.
And they call them skid marks and bacon strips.
Yeah. I remember that as a kid. Always the laundry. My dad had shit stains in every single pair of underwear.
Dude, my dad used to walk around all the time in skibbies. Like, he
yeah.
would, after 8
yeah,
p.m.,
yeah, yeah.
dude, he hit the skibs on. And he would come down. I had, like, my girlfriend over, and I was, like, sucking her tits. And he came downstairs, saw me sucking tits, and was like, knock it off. And it was like, I'm going to bed, and walked upstairs. His fucking little dong hanging out of his underwear. Hey, what are you doing?
I
was
yeah,
like,
I used to wear. You used to wear skibbies, right, when you were a kid?
Yeah. I, oh, yeah.
yeah, when you were a young boy, you
I
wear
the colored
skibbies.
Yeah.
Skibs.
Yeah.
And geezers hang on to that.
Dude, they just wear skivs.
I guarantee my dad still wears skivs.
I know. I think my dad might have like 2 pairs of boxer briefs. My sister's got them or something. But
Jesus
like,
Christ.
He's rocking those white skivvies. And he even says he'll give it like 3 streaks. And then he's like, all right, I got to ditch them. He shamelessly shits his pants. He does not. I'd be at work with him. We were like on a ladder and he'd be above me. And he'd fart on a ladder on the way up to a roof. And then we'd get on a roof. It'd be like 10 mph winds. And I'm like, dude, it fucking still stinks. He'd be like, I might have shit myself. And he'll just go down the ladder, come back up. And it's just like.
He's like a third grader.
He doesn't give a fuck. He's like, oh, man.
Oh, man.
He calls it drawing mud. He's like, I drew mud.
I fucking drew mud in third grade.
Did you really?
I sharted at the end of the day. I fucking sharted as a young boy. In third grade, right? I remember it was right before the buses were coming.
You shart your pants?
I sharted.
Oh, no.
And it fucking stunk, dude. It fucking stunk. Holy fuck. And then I got home and told on myself at dinner. Oh, my family dinner. They're like,
why'd you tell yourself?
I don't know.
You used to tell
I
yourself.
I thought it'd be funny.
You?
Oh, really? I used to always tell myself. If I did anything wrong, I told myself.
Jesus Christ.
But my dad was like, how was your day? And I was like, it was messy. I still get made fun of for that.
We used to play, did you ever play Smear the Queer when you were little?
Yeah.
We used to play, me and my cousin were playing one-on-one Smear the Queer in my front yard one time, and I fucking...
One-on-one? Yeah, just fighting.
We're just tackling each other. And I nailed him in the stomach, and he shit his pants in my front yard. And he ran all the way home. He went to his house, and he comes out of the bathroom, and he's like, look, holding up his boxers, like, I shit my pants. And his mom comes in and fucking grounded him. He wasn't allowed out the rest of the night. His own shitty boxers in the kitchen.
I had this, one of my favorite games as a kid was, I had a pretty big backyard and a deck. And my mom played tennis, so we had this fucking trash can full of tennis balls.
Yeah.
And my dad would bring it out, put it on the porch, and we would run around in the backyard, and he would fucking throw them at us as hard as he could.
Holy fuck.
He had a fucking can.
That must have been so fun.
It was so fun, but at my birthday party, I was like, yeah, let's play the tennis ball game. So I had all these kids in the backyard, and my dad was up there drinking, throwing shit at us, and he fucking... I'll never forget it. This kid stopped and did like the hands on the side of his head. Oh. Like, nah.
He did moose ears.
He was just standing there with moose ears, and my dad fucking gunned one, and it connected on this kid's balls, right to his fucking balls, so hard. And the kid had to go home. He had to call his mom and pick him up, and he left my party. Because my dad hit him in the nuts with a tennis ball.
Whoa, getting moose ears.
He's standing there, this little pudgy fuck. Matt Krause got hit in the nuts with a tennis ball. I vividly remember him also saying, that's my family weak spot.
That's my family weak
spot. Oh, man.
Dude, he must have been moose ears, dropped to knee.
Oh, it was the best thing in the world.
Bright red.
It was the best thing in the world. Got fucking drilled in the balls.
Oh, my God.
My dad hit my cousin in the balls, too, doing that. It was funny, too, because he would do this thing, because he would try to hide under the porch. You could hide under there, and he couldn't throw
him
at
you.
But he figured out how to fucking bounce him. Like, he would lean over the railing and bounce him straight down. And he fucking gunned when it bounced and hit my cousin.
I saw someone get hit in the nuts with a paintball gun.
That's awesome.
We were playing paintball, and someone got shot right in the dick. My friend Del Grande got hit right in the fucking dick and dropped. And then, like, my cousin came up in between rounds. We were playing, like, an organized thing. He came up and point-blanked me right in the ass. Dude, it fucking hurt so bad. So I was all pissed off. The next game, like, it gets all foggy. You can't really see shit.
Yeah.
So I'm, like, crawling underneath. I'm like, dude, I think, like, no one knows where this place is. I'm in, like, a secret fucking, they don't know where I am. I'm going to fuck these guys up because I could see people milling around.
Yeah.
I come out of the bushes like fucking Rambo, and this was, like, from 5 feet, like, bah, 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 bah. And they're like, dude, we're fucking out, you dickhead. They're... I lit up. It was like some other like group playing that was out of the game, and I came out of the bushes like a wild man.
You didn't even know them?
They were just like, there was like multiple groups. I came out, I was like, pa 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 pa. They were like, what the fuck? I ran back in.
And you ran back away. You didn't even talk to them.
I had a fucking full on face cover, dude. I was just like, peace. The one dude's mask was flipped up too.
Oh, that's awesome.
It's so fun.
God, that's great. All right.
Good cast.
That's a good cast. Yeah, let's end it there.
All right.
All right, thanks, everyone.
Do you have anything?
Suck our dicks.
Yeah, fuck you.
Do I have anything? This weekend, black show on Friday. So
yeah, 6 at 9.
If you're listening
on that
to this,
Sunday.
You're probably not a black guy going to that show.
Yeah.
And,
Brian Six's show, 6 at 9.
6 at 9.
Victoria Freehouse, is that?
Yeah, I think so.
That'd be tight.
And then Saturday, I'm at Steel Stacks in Bethlehem with the Tommy Pope.
Hell yeah.
Also one of our gods, dude.
Hell
one
yeah.
of our demigods.
The Pope's there, dude.
I mean, McKeevey's is our one true savior.
Exactly.
Tommy Pope's one of his right hand. He's St. Peter.
He's an angel in heaven,
yeah,
definitely.
He's definitely an angel. All right.
Bye.
That's it.
Praise the Lord, I was born to travel. Feeling like Slash in front of the chapel.